So first, let's take a look at the layout of Sensory Percussion. The software is organized according to the four different sensor channels. So you'll see down here, there are four main channels. Drum 1, drum 2, drum 3, drum 4. And those will correspond to the various sensors that you have plugged in. In the center here is the what we call the pad view, and it shows you all the different zones that your drum can activate. And on the left side is the library area where you can navigate through our preset kits, make bookmarks to places on your desktop to find your own presets and your own samples, as well as look through our samples and effects. On the top here, there is a controllers tab, which allows you to navigate all the controllers that are specific to any given kit. On the right side is where all the sound and MIDI is produced. So it's we call it the audio MIDI output area. And it's where you can add samplers, drag samples, add effects, and edit all your MIDI mappings. On the bottom right, this is an area for channel-specific effects. So this is contextual to which channel you have selected. So if I add a tube amp on channel 3 and then I click on channel 4, you see that there's no effect there. It's specific to channel 3. And this is also how you add effects to the sends and the master. On the top here is your kit navigator ribbon. So these will hold each kit preset, and you can arrange them in whatever order you want. So let's say you're playing a show, you'll put them as song 1, song 2, song 3, etc. On the left is the file button, which allows you to load a new set, open a previously saved set, open recent sets, save your set, and manage your set in various ways. On the very top of the app, you'll see a mute button and a volume knob. This controls how loud the volume is when you click on a pad. And you can quickly mute it or unmute it, depending on if you want to hear something when you click on a pad. Undo redo button, the audio settings panel, where you can select your audio interface and your input-output routing. And the app settings button, which has certain settings for how Sensory Percussion is set up, like turning data collection on or off, how loud it is when you audition samples in the library, auto crosstalk cancellation options, and an option for a shorter app UI in case you have a smaller screen. Most tasks in the software can be accomplished with simple drag and drop actions, from presets to samples to controllers and effects. When you drag something in the software will light up showing you where something can be dropped. So it's a very simple logic that applies across the entire app. So for instance, when I go into a sample folder and drag a sample, you'll see the pads lighting up, which means I can drag it and drop it onto a pad. If I go to effects and drag an effect, I can drag this also onto a pad, and you'll see that it adds it to the pad effects slot. I can drag an entire preset up to the top ribbon. And if I go inside of a preset, I can drag a drum down to a channel. And with controllers, you'll see that I can drag controllers to control nearly any parameter in the software, from parameters on effects to triggering pads to kit navigation, or to the parameters on the mixer.